We are finally taking a look at Valiant Comics today with their popular character, Bloodshot, to see if we could really create nanobot-powered super soldiers. Plus, we explore the real science behind hacking into your memories. At least, I think we are. I can't really remember. Bloodshot is a character from Valiant Comics who is essentially a living weapon. He was experimented on by the shady group known as Project Rising Spirit and injected with billions of nanites throughout his body that give him superhuman abilities. Abilities like enhanced strength, speed, reflexes, and endurance, as well as an incredible healing factor, plus the ability to shapeshift. Unfortunately, this experiment came at a high cost. All of Bloodshot's memories from before the injection of nanites were completely erased. He is entirely unaware of who he was before Project Rising Spirit. This group used Bloodshot as a means to deal with threats all around the world that would be too dangerous or even impossible for anyone else. And while that sounds all nice and good, the method they used to control Bloodshot is a bit disturbing. PRS implanted dozens of false memories of families and friends and lives he never had into his mind in order to motivate Bloodshot into completing his missions. For example, hey Bloodshot, kill everyone in this town because your wife and son's lives depend on it, even though you don't really have a wife or a son, we just made you think that you do in order to get you to do our bidding. Alright, get to it. Leave no soul alive. That is pretty messed up, which is why when Bloodshot became aware of this, he understandably was pretty upset. His new mission then became piecing together his real past to discover who he used to be before he was experimented on. I've been challenged by the people at Valiant Comics to dissect the character of Bloodshot, so while I could have made a video exploring the many ethical considerations of transhumanism, I wanted to take the opportunity to instead talk about the science of Bloodshot, though we did discuss transhumanism on this week's podcast, so you can listen to that if you want. The folks at Valiant told me that they pride themselves on being, quote, the world outside your window, just tilted a few degrees. So a lot of the science is theoretically possible or scientifically correct. And I want to put this to the test and answer two interesting questions that Bloodshot poses. Number one, how realistic are these nanites coursing through his blood? And number two, can false memories be planted in our brains? So let's tackle these one by one. First, let's explore those nanites. As we briefly mentioned earlier, Bloodshot's nanites are responsible for his superhuman abilities. So how do these fictional nanites stack up with real-world equivalents? Well, kinda good, kinda bad. There have been all kinds of advancements in the field of molecular nanotechnology, but a lot of it is still theoretical, like the respirocyte, which are hypothetical artificial red blood cells that would be able to carry 236 times more oxygen throughout the body. If Bloodshot's nanites functioned like respirocytes, it would explain his superhuman endurance, as well as his ability to hold his breath underwater for hours. Some nanotechnology is indeed real, however. In 2015, micromotor-powered nanobots delivered the first medicinal payload inside of a living creature. They introduced the nanobots into a mouse, which reacted to the mouse's stomach acid and produced little bubbles, turning the nanobots into teeny tiny rockets, which fired themselves into the mouse's stomach lining. This allowed the scientists to use the nanobots as a method of delivering a compound directly to the mouse's stomach tissue. You're gonna hear about a lot of experiments done on mice in this episode. I hope you're not averse to that. As this technology evolves, we might see nanoparticles used to deliver all kinds of drugs and compounds directly to different parts of the body. And this is something that's been demonstrated with Bloodshot's nanites, like when they manually flooded his brain with dopamine to reward him for completing one of his missions. Another important feature of Bloodshot's nanites is the ability to directly communicate with him and give him status updates regarding the condition of his body. And believe it or not, this is in line with a current project that is developing nanoparticles which will hopefully help detect cancer and other diseases in the host. The company developing these nanobots, by the way, is Google. Because of course it's Google, who else would it be? Once Google's nanoparticles are introduced to your system via a pill, they will course through your body gathering data. The nanoparticles will send the data to a wristband that the user wears and provide them with knowledge of their own body at a cellular and molecular level. A little different than how Bloodshot can literally talk to his nanites, but I'm willing to say that that's probably only like that in the comics to aid us readers so that we can see a visual representation of the nanites and him communicating. Also, not an Apple Watch. Stop asking me if it's an Apple Watch. I'm not made of money. I do YouTube. Still, there's no signs of nanobots giving someone the ability to shapeshift like Bloodshot can, nor are there any prominent advancements in using nanobots to grant a user superhuman healing, although there have been a few groups like DARPA who are reportedly exploring the idea of improved healing of soldiers through something like nanobots. This one is a bit of a toss-up for me, but since the Valiant universe is supposed to be our own world, just slanted a bit, I'll give them a point for Bloodshot's nanites being at least pretty close to what science is working on today. But if we want to build a Bloodshot, the nanites are only half the story. The other important step Project Rising Spirit took when crafting their perfect weapon was to implant false memories into his head that would allow them some form of control. As Dr. Emmanuel Curatech, a PRS scientist who worked on the Bloodshot experiment, explained, Project Rising Spirit filled Bloodshot's head with dozens of fictional wives, children, and friends, tailor-made for every possible scenario. His brain is like a TV. They change the channel and he becomes absorbed in a new show, a show that Bloodshot thinks is his life, but it's not. They do this to motivate him. He'll kill anyone they point him at if it means protecting the ones he loves. Can this exist in real life? Can Project Rising Spirit plant false memories into Bloodshot's mind? Believe it or not, yes. Well, sort of. Let me explain. Technically speaking, we do it to ourselves all the time. Our brains are great at taking experiences and condensing them down into general lessons learned and anything it thinks you'll need for later. But the details of our memories, and even the sources of them, are often completely discarded. Bloodshot has the benefit of being able to access his memories, even the false ones, like a computer hard drive, preserving every last detail and nuance. Us? Not so lucky. We discussed this in our Batman video about whether or not Bruce Wayne accurately remembers the death of his parents, so watch that one for a refresher, but the basic idea is that even just the act of recalling a memory itself changes it, physically changes how that memory is wired in your brain. In fact, recalling a memory should really be called updating a memory, because each time you reflect on a past experience, you modify it. The more you dwell on a memory, the less accurate it becomes until it's almost entirely fabricated with false details. So the takeaway here is that our brains are crowded with fiction. Don't trust anything you remember. Sit in a corner and have an existential crisis about how your most precious childhood memories probably never happened. Happy birthday. Statistically, at least one of you guys has a birthday today. But I'll grant you that Project Rising Spirit is going way beyond the typical false memories that we create in our day-to-day lives. These are memories tailor-made to specifically suit Bloodshot and his mission, uploaded directly to his brain. Is that possible? Could PRS selectively implant false memories into Bloodshot's head that would influence his behavior? Yes. At least in theory. In the past few years, scientists have demonstrated that they can plant false memories inside of mice. Crazy, right? Unbelievable, even. As in, Scott, I don't believe you, stop making things up, I like supersuits better, unsubscribed. Okay, I mean, that's certainly a reaction you could have. For the rest of you who are wondering how the scientists were able to do this, to give mice false memories, it's pretty fascinating. One study called, I kid you not, Project Inception used optogenetics. Basically, the researchers used mice that were genetically engineered to have light-sensitive proteins in their brain cells that the scientists could stimulate with lasers. This allowed them to find a specific memory in the mouse's brain and turn that memory on and off at will, like a light switch. With that system in place, the researchers set up an experiment involving two boxes. Box A was a perfectly nice and pleasant box that the mouse had good memories of. The scientists then put the mouse into box B, which gave the mouse mild electric shocks. But here's the trick. At the instant the mouse would get shocked, the scientists would use a laser to trigger the mouse's memory of box A. When the mouse was reintroduced to box A, the perfectly fine and non-shocky box, it instantly froze in fear. The mouse recognized the box and remembered being shocked in it, even though that never happened. The scientists had successfully planted a false memory. That is nothing short of amazing, and also a little terrifying, but not as terrifying as this next study, which I can only assume was an attempt to one-up the aforementioned Project Inception. Neuroscientists in France wanted to see if they could plant a false conscious memory in a mouse while the mouse was sleeping. They did this by putting mice in an enclosed arena with many different locations and just letting them explore. Later on, when the mice were sleeping, the researchers monitored the mice's neurons and found which brain cells coincided with a mouse's memory of a specific location inside the arena. Whenever that neuron fired, electrodes hooked up to the mouse would stimulate the reward centers of their brain. When the mice woke up, they immediately and consciously went straight towards the location in the arena that they remember being rewarded in, even though they were never actually rewarded there. It was a false memory that the researchers planted while the mouse was having little mousy dreams. That's both awesome and extremely unsettling. But I can already hear you now. These studies aren't really planting false memories, they're just altering existing memories. Completely different than Bloodshot having full, complex memories of past lives uploaded to his head. And that's totally fair. But the general concept still applies. Project Rising Spirit was planting false memories as a method of influencing Bloodshot's behavior in a way that they could control, similar to what these scientists were doing with these mice. And sure, while we aren't able to upload complex memories or skills directly to the human brain just yet, these studies are steps closer to that reality. The researchers on these studies each echoed sentiments about how planting false memories isn't physically impossible. It would just be unbelievably, astronomically difficult. And if Valiant is supposed to be our own world, just tilted a few degrees, I might give this one to them. So to recap, the nanites in Bloodshot's body are just much more sophisticated versions of already existing nanoparticle technology, and Project Rising Spirit's ability to plant false memories in Bloodshot as a method of motivation is something that science has already done, just not to the extreme scale of the comics. Is it possible that we could create a super soldier, a living weapon like Bloodshot? Certainly not right now, but as science continues down these avenues, it's looking more and more likely. You win this time, Valiant. You win this time. What do you guys think? Would you like to have billions of nanites coursing through your body like Bloodshot? Are you scared that someone planted a false memory into your brain while you were sleeping last night? I wasn't before, but now I am. What other Valiant characters should we talk about on the show? Let me know in the comments below. And if you want to learn more about memory, make sure you check out that Batman video I mentioned earlier about whether or not the Dark Knight can accurately recall the night his parents were murdered. Spoilers, he probably can't. Click right here to learn why. We've also got a video about the science behind whether or not Deadpool is secretly a mutant. Both videos are some of my absolute favorites, so click on one to check them out. And make sure you hit that big sexy subscribe button so you don't miss out on all the new videos we make for you every week that explore the history, science, art, and philosophy behind your favorite comic book superheroes. My name is Scott, and I will see you right here on Friday for another video. See ya.